Sneaking done. Fighting now. Over. Time to fight. Was that all? This one looks pretty tough. Was that all? Sneaking done. Fighting now. Fighting over. Thank you. Time to fight.
Scanning for hostiles. Please clear the area until order has been received.
To steal the H2 transmitter array antenna, are you? You won't succeed. Not if my lethal robo scorpions have any say in the matter.
Sneaking done. Fighting now.
Tail locking on. Go, my minion. Sting them in the name of all that is Mobius. Thank you.
monsters have stealth suits too. Fighting over. This one looks pretty tough. Sneaking gun, fighting now. Fighting over. Data collection array online. Please use the terminal below to begin user synchronization. I bet no one has ever been as unnoticed as me.
Hello, sir.
This is the basic stealth test. The robots will be looking for us, but we won't let them find us. bad. We were spotted by robots. If you go back to the terminal restart the test, I won't mess up again. This should be easy, as long as I don't screw up again. Stealth boys are a robot's big weakness. This should be easy, as long as I don't screw up again. Stealth boys are a robot's big weakness. Uh-oh. This should be easy, as long as I don't screw up again. That's all. Ready, steady, fighty.
I wish there were some other way we could have worked this out.
Big weakness.
Hold still, please. It's harder to hit you if you keep running.
Fighting over. Oh, that's too bad. Those robots would normally help defend us and the facility if we're attacked. This should be easy, as long as I don't screw up again. Test data processed. Firmware updated to version 1.1. Boot damping sensors online. Robot bugs. That's all. Ready, steady, fighty.
Our little life to be free. Do not attempt to breach the fake mountain force fields. Doing so could allow dangerous ideas and or creatures having those ideas to escape.
This one looks pretty tough. Was that all? I bet no one has ever been as unnoticed as me.
I can hear your penis-tipped feet tromping around. Did you retrieve the technologies yet? We need them, as I have indicated. What? You did? Your survival, let alone success, barely registered in my projections. Now, all I need to do is check my transmission databank. Mobius is always filling it up with his psychotic calls. Oh yes, there's the schematics, just like you said. How truthful. Yes. Yes. Yes, yes, No, I mean yes! You just need to analyze these technologies for a moment. They are extremely advanced, you know? I know how these technologies work. Of course I know. If you remember, we described them in clearly abstract, contradictory statements before. Why would we do that if we weren't certain on how to use them? Yes. So let me... a bit, huh? I'll figure it out. I suppose it could. If it could be quiet for more than a few moments, always talking, touching things. It does have an interface disruptor weave against electronics, like the Forbidden Zone door. Let me check something. Of course! I have it! The override sequence to open the Forbidden Zone door is hidden in the schematics. Well, not hidden. It's actually right there, behind the programming equivalent of coffee stains. It's embedded in what seems to be recursive code. It's badly commented there and there. Oh, and null pointers. Very sloppy, Mobius. You see, using the antenna to boost the emitter's sonic frequency and the stealth suit to bypass the Forbidden Zone lock, yes, that could work. Was that my plan? It must have been. Sometimes I truly surprise myself. The door is open, and now Mobius will get his. The door should be unsealed. Now, instead of being subjected to threats, we can now send an equally threatening message to Mobius. And that message is science! Deliver this message, and Big Mountain shall be freed from Mobius's reign of terror! You can go now. That's your cue.
Sneaking done. Fighting now. Was that all? Ready, steady, fighty. Bad guys dealt with. Time to fight. Cessation of hostilities complete. This one looks pretty tough.
Steal them in the name of all that is obvious!
Was that all? Ready, steady, fighting. Was that all?
His robo-scorpions crawl everywhere in search of intelligence to devour and stupefy.
Oh, hello there. You are there, aren't you? Forgive my confusion. So hard to tell these days. You seem familiar somehow. I'm guessing you're here for your brain, perhaps? It's just up there. Such a nice brain, young, very bright. A little hard to see you. Can you walk into my left? Right, FOV coon? Ah, that's it. You're coming into focus nicely. Whoa, did I leave that on? I thought I'd powered it down. Was wondering what was causing the power outages. Oh, well, that's good. Were we supposed to fight? I certainly don't feel violent, but, well, these contraptions make it hard to tell. Really? That implies preconceived notions, theories, and a hypothesis about this meeting? Please extrapolate. What was I supposed to be like? After all, it might be worth a cognitive realignment if your theoretical Mobius is better than I. Oh, a variety of raisins. You're something of a homily. The anomaly? You're really quiet special, and not in the cranially challenged way. You see, you are the most successful brain extraction experiment ever performed here at Big Mountain. A victim of your own success, as it were. If you were to go back with what your brain knows about the procedure, well, your brain could be popped back in and you could walk right out of here. Can't have brains moving around of their own volition. I'm not sure, except that I'm sure there's a very good reason for it. I have very good reasons for almost everything I do. Even if I forget them occasionally. Although I feel this one is especially important. Oh well! Now, that seems to be rather hormonal of you. Flight or fight response, you know. Hard to cut that out completely. Your brain is here, safe with me. We chat over mentats. Oh, curiosity. I experienced that less now that I know everything. Oh, maybe it was when I found out some unpleasant answers. Do you? You seem fine without it. And does it even want to go back with you? Maybe you should ask it. It's quite independent, has all manner of opinions. Tell you what, I'll leave it up to your brain. If it wants to go, then fine. If not, well, you should respect its wishes. Indeed. The goodbye part of our little chat, then. Goodbye. Please mind the equations on the floor.
Dragged themselves in out of the wasteland. And where have we been, Crawling through bits of radioactive muck again? Ah, lovely. Figure that out, have we? Would you like a cookie? Oh, had I? What exactly will you do if I don't? Not put me back in that cranial dungeon you call your head? Heavens forbid. You wouldn't. That's inhuman. You're a monster! A deranged, self-destructive monster! I'm not going to lie to you. The prospect is definitely not that appealing. Look at it from my perspective. Here I have peace, quiet, and safety. Well, barring the odd rogue scorpion. In your head, I've got poison, radiation, grisly injuries, and biological functions. Do you know how much more you can get done when you're not constantly looking for places to urinate? It's quite a lot, I can tell you. Overrated biological feedback. Believe me, you only feel that way because you've got all that meat oozing hormones. Oh no! Please, don't leave me here in this nice, safe dome where I have access to nutritive fluids and a fully indexed library. Please don't deprive me of being dragged through a landscape so bleak it was actually improved by the end of the world. I don't know how I could bear it. What did you think all those self-preservation instincts were, All those times you thought for a fleeting second, maybe I shouldn't punch that death claw in the face. That was me telling you exactly how I felt before! Crawl back in there? Are you mad? I don't know where you've been. For all I know, you're riddled with disease or packing one of those delightful head wounds you seem to attract. I'm not crawling back into your head just to ooze right back out again. While the brute force approach is a lovely one, really, it won't work. Even if I wanted to settle myself back in your skull and go to all the trouble of reconnecting nerve endings, Dr. Mobius doesn't have the tools here. We would have to make use of Dr. Klein's lab, and I rather doubt the brains are inclined to share. And you believe them? Really? I know you were recently deprived of my fabulous advice, but... Really? Once I'm delivered into their clutches, they'll find a way past the radar fence and the whole Mojave will be their playground. And that is assuming, of course, that one of them doesn't take a fancy to our body and decide to slip his own brain into it instead. Don't seem so bad. They vivisected us just to see what would happen. Have you forgotten the lobotomites? The cyber dogs, I assume you saw those. Imagine that kind of science spread across the entire Mojave. Every man, woman, and child we've met reduced to a lobotomite. Is that what you want? Oh, Lovely. We've reached the mindless violence portion of the program. Tell me, what exactly are you, and I use the word loosely, planning? I see. And you plan to be standing in the midst of this mayhem? Well, that's a novel strategy. I'd like to find a nice little place to live, maybe in Good Springs, and settle down where we won't get shot at. Not as often, at any rate. But since that doesn't seem likely, what's your plan? Very well. I suppose I have no choice. Goodbye, peaceful, soothing brain jar. Hello, head wounds and scorpions. I suppose now that we're reunited, you'll want to fill your torso up with those other meaty parts the think tank took from us. Personally, I think your upgrades are quite a bit better. But now that I'm with you, the sink's autodock can plug them back in no problem. Right then, off we go. Klein will be in for a nasty shock when he realizes the pacification field won't work on a mind and body reunited.